गुड मॉर्निंग प्रिंसिपल सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग।
স্যার আমরা কি শুরু করব?
একটু একটু ওয়েট করে যাই।
আচ্ছা ঠিক আছে স্যার।
ম্যাডাম শুরু করে দিন, পরে যারা জয়েন করবে।
ঠিক আছে স্যার। গুড মর্নিং টু অল অফ ইউ। টুডে উই আর গ্যাদার্ড হিয়ার অন দিস ভার্চুয়াল প্ল্যাটফর্ম টু ডিসকাস অন মুকস, দ্যাট ইজ দ্য ম্যাসিভ ওপেন অনলাইন কোর্সেস। The concept was first emerged as the result of Open Educational Resources or OER movement, and the term MOOCs was first coined in the year 2008. From 2012 onwards, MOOCs started occupying a significant place in higher education because of its several advantages, such as open or online mode, self-paced course designs, inclusion of massive numbers of learners at a time, etc., in contrast to the traditional classroom teaching. Of the hour for us to adopt and apply improved technologies towards achieving the quality in higher education. Now I may take the opportunity to introduce honorable resource person of today's webinar, Mr. Shiv Shankar Dash. He is the Network Engineer VC in the Department of Continuing Education and Technology, IIT Kharagpur. On behalf of my college, I express my gratitude to him for being with us today. We are going to learn from him how MOOCs can be created and developed by us and by all the faculty members of higher education institutions. Now I request the Honorable Principal of Dhrupachar Haldar College, Dr. Shubhabrata Shahu, to deliver the welcome address. Sir, please.
Good morning. Honorable Speaker, respected teachers and distinguished participants. It is my great pleasure to welcome all of you to today's webinar on MOOCs for Us, Liberating Knowledge Beyond Classroom, jointly organized by Central Library, Dhrupachand Haldar College and IQSE, Dhrupachand Haldar College. Firstly, I would like to offer my thanks to Mrs. Sudeshna Moitro, librarian, Dhrupachand Haldar College, organizing secretary of this webinar, and Professor Sudokhina Sengupta, coordinator, IQSE of Dhrupachand Haldar College. Trends of online teaching learning in higher education. Faculty members towards adopting technology in teaching, and MOOCs also carry considerable weightage in the Dhrupachand Haldar College help faculty learn
in certain JAM or GATE examination or something like that, and some part of that syllabus is covered in a particular course where the fundamentals are actually given stress on, then definitely students will find these materials very, very useful. It's not only the looking for the job or looking for joining some higher learning institution. Some people will definitely look for starting their own business. Want to start a business? It's not a very easy task either. A lot of other skills requirement. That is, they should know how to prepare a plan, how to get the funding, the sales strategy, the logistic part. If there is a failure, how do they cope up with the failures? So communication, sales, focus, business strategy, ability to learn from the failures. These are the things that they should be able to inculcate in them before they jump into this. But you tell me, how many of these skill sets are part of our regular curriculum? Possibly none. But being an academic institution, it's not only the role of us is to just teach what is there in the syllabus, but also motivate the students to learn newer things that they want to pursue in future. Once they want to go for the job market, it's not that, okay, I have done, say, master's in physics, so I have got a very good score, 70, 80, 90% score, that is going to fetch me the, a job. There are certain soft skills or cognitive skills that we call communication skill, critical thinking, creativity, how do I manage people, how do we coordinate with people, emotional quotient on emotional intelligence. These are negotiation, complex problem solving skill. These skills are actually contribute 50% weightage on getting a job. So 50% weightage goes to the hard skill, that physics, chemistry, mathematics that I have studied, and the grade that matters is only 50%. But the remaining 50% will be looked after on these aspects. The faculty or the prospective employers will be judging the candidates on this front. But unfortunately, our syllabuses, be it AICT or be it UGC curriculum, they really possibly do not take into account all these issues. So online sources can be extremely beneficial to support the students on this aspect. So how NPT, how MOOCs can be useful, particularly for the students' perspective, they can learn newer or emerging technologies irrespective of which field of study they are studying. Your physics student may be interested to learn something, say psychology, but your regular syllabuses or regular structure may not permit the physics student to take a regular course from humanities department. But since online courses gives that cross-discipline learning advantage, so if they have an interest to learn the things, they can learn the subjects that interest them, irrespective of their domain of specialization. They can learn new domain of knowledge from other disciplines, improve their employability prospect, prepare better for the competitive exam, entrepreneurship skills can be developed much better, and once they leave the academic institution, during the entire career span, because of the changing technology outside, there will be lot of, you can say, frequently they will be required to learn newer things, but there will not be any teacher like you to teach them on the newer subjects. So they really need to inculcate how to learn from that, you can say, your college life itself, if not started in the school days. So it should be part of the lifelong learning. They really need to know how to learn on themselves from the available resources that they get. Now, this was about student perspective, why they should consider joining MOOCs. Even the present guidelines by the Government of India, through the UGC notification number 271 dated July 18, they said that if a faculty member wants to rise onto the career path from assistant professor to assistant professor senior scale to assistant professor selection gate to associate professor level, there is a component of online certification program. That means I have just extracted the exact wording from the notification. Says that the contribution, either they complete one MOOC course in the relevant subject with e-certification or contribute towards development of e-content in four quadrant. Then what is this fourth quadrant? That we'll talk about a little later. And minimum of 10 modules of a course or contribution towards development of at least 10 modules of MOOCs courses or contribution towards conducting of a MOOCs course during the period of assessment. So this is what UGC notification says. I really do not know whether this UGC notification is applicable for colleges like you. Okay, but this is a notification. MOOCs for performance assessment of college or university teachers. Here also it says that assessment of performance of college and university teachers for the cash promotion, career advancement scheme promotion is based on the following criteria. Here also you'll find attending orientation or refresher methodology courses, development of e-content and MOOCs. Here also MOOCs comes into picture. So even for your performance assessment also, MOOCs will be playing a pivotal role. Now calculating academic research score of teachers. You find that under serial number 3, MOOCs will carry certain points for the faculty of engineering as well as faculty of humanities, social science, library, education, these all things. You have got almost development of complete MOOC, 20 points, MOOCs per module lecture. Means in totality, if I see 20 plus 5 plus 20 plus 5 plus 2 plus 8, these all contents are, these all points are there for calculating the academic or research score of the teachers, both for the engineering as well as non-engineering branches. Now, so far we have seen, what is the perspective of the students and the faculty members or their career progression, be it in either cases. Now we'll take out a sample example like online certification program. As I said, online certification program in India was started by IITs and IISc way back in 2014 through a program called NPTEL. That is National Program on Technology Enhanced Learning. It's a project of MHRD, or now renamed as Ministry of Education, Government of India, under the National Mission NMEICT. Okay. So it was started by 7 older IITs like Bombay, IIT Delhi, IIT Bombay, IIT Guwahati, IIT Kanpur, IIT Kharagpur, IIT Madras, IIT Roorkee, and single IISc Bangalore. It was started in 2006-3 when we have actually captured the lectures delivered by the IIT faculties in our regular classroom. We have recorded those contents and made it available to the learner communities outside, so that the quality of teaching learning process is improved. So it was a vision to provide high quality affordable education at large scale. During this period, 2003 to 2013, these phases, we have actually captured the lectures from the classrooms, and we have also provided something like web courses where the course contents are developed in a PDF document format with a lot of animation. Huge number of contents were available, made, and they were made available to the colleges or any interested learner. They could collect the contents from our NPTEL offices by sending the hard disks or buying the CD drives, courses in the CD-ROM drives at that point of time. Now from 2014, as I said, that we have started the online certification program, and we are also conducting the certification examination. From 2016, it is going under Swayam NPTEL banner. We are also promoting the use and adoption of these courses by the colleges and universities as per the regulation prescribed by the UGC and AICTE. Currently, just to give you a statistics, we have more than 2,900 courses developed under this program. And these courses are not only coming from IIT, so it has to be engineering. No. We have got a huge number of courses coming from humanities and social science, basic sciences, management, law, all these areas. So it's not only engineering, other disciplines are also given due it. We offer these contents through two portals. One is YouTube and our nptel.ac.in portal. In YouTube, our contents are subscribed by more than 3.1 million. Please note that these are high quality academic contents, not entertainment channel. So having this many subscriptions speaks that, okay, how the learner community across the globe views the contents coming from IITs. It has got more than 1 billion views, and we are also converting the lectures into English subtitles as well as converting into the regional languages also, so that the students who are coming from vernacular medium, who have studied up to class 12 in local languages, say Bengali, if they find it difficult to follow the English lectures, we convert it into the Bengali text so that they can understand better. Now, online courses. We are saying, and your CAS document is also saying, the contents have to be developed in a 4-quadrant approach. Okay. Now this, how do we say it's a 4-quadrant approach? And if you want to develop a course, whom do you approach? Okay. On the bottom of this, this is swayam.gov.in. If you want to go to the portal, you go there and you'll find at the bottom, there are 3, 6, 9 national coordinators. Each coordinator has got a specific role to play in the whole online certification sphere. Everyone is given a responsibility to target a set of students' community. Like if you are looking for online courses primarily for the school children, that is K-12 level, then National Institute of Open Schooling and NCERT are the agencies whom one should approach with the course proposal. It's like Dhruvachand Haldar College, a faculty member from here wants to offer a course. Now, depending on what type of course you are planning, you have to actually approach the right coordinator, because each coordinator has been given a specific task to coordinate a set of courses which will be targeting a particular set of student community. CEC, that is a Consortium for Educational Communication, is the nodal agency for offering any online certification course that is at the undergraduate level and non-engineering, non-management. So CEC, the agency, if you are planning to offer a course from non-engineering, non-management, but level is undergraduate, CEC, Consortium for Educational Communication. If the course is of PG level, that is PG level, non-engineering, non-management, then UGC is the national coordinator for such courses, and the course proposal should be addressed to UGC. Then comes other courses are management. If the course is from the management, both UGC level, then IIM Bangalore is the nodal agency or the national coordinator. Then comes NPTEL. As I said, NPTEL is a umbrella body of 7 older IITs and ISC Bangalore. We primarily are mandated to offer online courses both at the undergraduate and postgraduate level engineering courses. But since each IIT has got their basic science, humanities, social science, law, all these disciplines, larger disciplines, these all things, so we do offer courses from basic science, humanities, social science, law, all these areas also, management also. Okay, NITTR is primarily for the teachers training, like BLEA, DLEA type of training, that type of there. Indira Gandhi National Open University is the agency for offering diploma certificate level programs that they used to conduct it since ages through distance learning program, that now they offer it to the online certification program. AICT is for teaching, AICT is for offering courses for teachers training of engineering colleges. So these are the agencies. Depending on what type of course you are planning, you have to approach the right agency. But then what all things that should be given in the proposal and how the course structure should be framed, we'll just look into the next part. So open online course, these are actually offered in a model call. It can be anytime. It can be taken by the IIIM model. That means anyone having an interest to learn the subject should be able to join. There is no bar on entry qualification criteria. Just requirement is an internet connectivity. Advantage is I can learn whatever I wish at my own pace and time. It's not that teacher will teach between 9 to 10 or 9 to 11 and I have to be physically present in that class. These courses are delivered online, so I can decide at what time it is convenient for me and whether I should study half an hour today, 1 hour today, 2 hours today. I take my decision. This is a self-paced course. From the comfort of home, I don't have to go anywhere, and I can have the privilege of learning the subjects from the finest teachers or experts available in the country. Okay. And it's a low cost, means actually it's a zero cost. It's a fully supported by the government of India. Now we'll just look into the four quadrant approach. Even this is nothing new. This four quadrant approach is followed by all regular teachers in a brick and mortar classroom. Consider that you are teaching from the podium, addressing towards a large audience, and I put a camera in front of you, and whatever you deliver the talk, whether using say chalk and talk business or using a PowerPoint slide or just interacting with the students, I put a camera and record the complete proceedings. So that becomes my first quadrant, that is recording of the contents, course content, video lectures. Okay, now if I make these contents in a recorded format, MP4 format to the students, there's a concept called flipped classrooms where teacher will be giving it to the students so that students before coming to the class, they'll go through the contents time and again and will come to the class only for the interaction. Okay, because in a regular classroom, maybe hardly 5 or 10% of the students interact with the teacher. So if you want to make it more meaningful, maybe it makes sense that you record the lectures, make it available to the students so that they can go through the lectures, come out with the set of problems that they're facing, and the teacher can take the 1 hour classroom slot for discussion. Now in a MOOCs model, consider that you have given a lectures, pre-recorded lectures to the students as it is done in a flipped classroom. The students will go through the lectures, then they will have a lot of questions. But here in an online classroom, they cannot come and write back to, or interact with you in a physical face-to-face mode. So they are given a blog like the queries. That is the interaction, face-to-face interaction. A substitute of that takes place in a textual form. Through text chat, they will be sending the query to the teacher, and the teacher, as well as the teaching assistants associated with the course, will be responding to the student's query through chat box. These are the two components. Then, in a regular classroom structure, sometimes the teacher will be conducting the class test or quizzes that may be given some weightage, because in a regular classroom also, you have got some weightage for the internal assessment. Consider as part of the internal assessment, you are conducting a quiz. Here also in online courses, after the lectures are given, second quadrant, the teacher interacts with the students through a chat box. The students are given a weekly assignment, a set of questions that are evaluated by the teacher. So every week there is an assessment quiz related to that week's video. Suppose you are given 3 hours of video lecture, they'll read, interact, then solve the problems or solve the questions related to that week given as an assignment. Submit it within a required timeline. We usually say within 10 days timeline, you have to submit it. After they submit, they are graded, and the 11th day, they will see what is the score. So these three components have been given. Now, what is the fourth quadrant? Fourth quadrant is that suppose the teacher wants to give the student some handwritten notes, PowerPoint slides, some free wiki resources, so that the learning process, they can, the students, if they are interested, they can go deeper into the concept. If they are giving some free resources, same is also available here. So the four quadrants are video lectures, recording, take your discussion forum for interaction with the teacher. Third is assignment every week. And fourth one is the supplementary study materials. These are the four components. In addition to that, what we do in NPTEL? In NPTEL, we try to bring the teacher interacting with the students through a virtual mode. That is, the student will be physically available in YouTube live session. Students will be joining the session, the links will be shared beforehand, and the students can ask the teacher directly through the chat box, and the teacher will be picking up the question and answering the questions. So instead of four quadrant approach, as prescribed by the SWAYAM, we are also incorporating in NPTEL an additional component of live interactive session by the faculty. You may stop me at any point of time if you have got any doubt. The course structure. Here I'll say that course structure varies from agency to agency. The course structure that I am talking, just because I belong to NPTEL, so I can only talk about the course structure of NPTEL. But if you just see the courses coming from UGC, CEC, or any other national coordinator, they may be slightly different. Because in our courses, I have seen that our maximum duration is 12 weeks. Whereas for some of the courses of UGC, they are 14 weeks, 15 weeks, something like that. So please do not consider that the course structure is same for all. It is only, I'm just giving an example. Every week we follow certain structure depending on the course types and course duration. We usually follow three formats, 20 hours and 30 hours. Full semester course that we cover within a period of 12 weeks. You may say that your UG level curriculum, you take more than 40 hours of time or maybe 45 hours of time to complete one course in a semester. Please consider these 30 hours is very, very condensed. Here the teacher has been talking to the students through camera without even taking a minute's break. There is no interruption by the students asking the question. So even if there is a pause during the video editing, that pause is taken off. So 30 hours is continuously, teacher is actually talking about the subjects for this full 30 hours. So it's a very, very condensed, almost equivalent to 40 hours of regular classroom lecture. Okay, this we complete within a 12 weeks time at the rate of 2.5 hours of lecture per week. Here also there is some innovation. Global trend says that the attention span of a student is not more than 10 to 12 minutes, not even 10 minutes, is less than that. But our teachers, even in IIT system, they are not very comfortable to granular that course size from 1 hour to 10 minutes. That's a standard protocol that is followed by all, whether it's a course is coming from Princeton, Harvard, MIT, any other top universities who are offering courses in edX, Coursera, Udacity, Udemy. But they follow something like 10, 12 minutes is maximum. Otherwise, their individual lectures will be 4 minutes, 5 minutes, something like that. Our courses are of, each individual lecture will be of half an hour duration. That means for a 30-hour course, you will have 60 lectures. Every week, there will be 2.5 hours or 5 lectures per week. There will be one assignment per week. There is a forum for interaction, supplementary study materials, that is handwritten notes, PowerPoint slides, optional video-based interaction with faculty, as I have said, to YouTube, certification examination, but this is not mandatory. Whoever is attending the course is an optional by paying the fee. I've got a mid-sized course of 20 hours that we completed within 8 weeks time, and we take 4 weeks period to complete a 10 hours course. Okay, since these courses are also considered for credit, we do definitely identify some equivalency, credit equivalency in our certificate. We say 10 hour course is equivalent to 1 credit, 20 hour course is equivalent to 2 credits, and 30 hour course is equivalent to 3 credits. But why I have put 2 to 3 credits or 3 to 4 credits, the reason behind is that credit calculation I'll show a little later. How we have arrived to this point, we'll elaborate on this little later. Lecture video, usually 30 minutes duration. These contents are available from nptel.ac.in or from the YouTube channel of NPTEL HRD. Every week, every Monday, we release the contents. Okay, weekly 5 lectures will be available Monday morning when the course is offered. Discussion forum remains open once the enrollment process starts. Like November, beginning of the November, we have offered 590 courses from NPTEL. They are available for enrollment. So the day we open the courses, the course will be starting from 24th of January next year. But from November onwards, the courses have been open, the students have been enrolling, and the forum is open so that the students, after joining, they may ask some question that needs to be answered. So forum remains open from the date of enrollment till the exam is over and the results are declared. These are managed by the course faculty and the teaching assistants. In addition to that, you have got supplementary study material. It could be text transcript. As I said, if a student is coming from Bengali medium, studied up to class 12 in Bengali medium, definitely it's possible that once they are exposed to a lecture delivered by faculty member coming from, say, Kerala, there will be accent difference. Okay, so they may face difficulty in following the lecture. Try to provide the English text transcript. The way the faculty has said in the lecture, we try to provide the text transcript. This is part of the online certification, online course delivery process, let me tell you. So text transcript is converted, video is text, audio part is converted into the text. This text is made available to the students so that if they do not follow the verbal part, they can at least read out the text and slowly pick up the knowledge. We do share PowerPoint slides, handwritten notes, links to web learning resources. We are in the process of including Bengali. As I said, weekly there is an assignment. We do provide assignment along with the video on Monday morning. There will be about 10 to 20 questions from each in each assignment. We provide them 10 days time. This could be multiple choice type of questions, or maybe in a physics, chemistry, mathematics problem is given, they have to solve and just write the alphanumeric answer to the fill in the blank state, the area filling up the things. If the answer falls within a particular range specified by the faculty, this will be automatically graded, and after 10 days, as soon as the 10 days timeline is over, the student can go back to the portal and see their score in the assignment out of 100. They can submit the assignments multiple times. The submission can be done online as well as offline. If it is multiple choice type, definitely they will be submitting online through computer. Otherwise, there are some courses the faculty member might have asked something, particularly humanities. The faculty might have said that you have to write something within, say, 200 words time word limit. Do the thing, scan the document, upload onto the portal so that the faculty member can manually evaluate it and grade it. Okay. Why do the students take these courses? We have been regularly interacting with them, and this is some trend that I'm showing. Reason for taking the certification exam: to update my knowledge maximum, for getting a job or internship or placements, for research purpose, preparing for the competitive exam mandated by the college, that is trade transfer, to learn how MOOCs work, learning newer domains of knowledge, and so on. Yes, students are the main target where the students will be taking in larger numbers, but 19 to 20% of the exam registration candidates are the faculty members, and even 5% of the contribution comes from the or participation comes from the industry bodies. Now, credit transfer. As you know, in 2016 the SWAM came into existence, and later on in 2016 only AICT and UGC, the two higher education regulators, have prescribed that the colleges can actually take, or universities can actually take, 20% of the credit courses per semester from SWAM courses, SWAM platform. Now this has been actually enhanced to 40% level after the pandemic struck. This is a notification from, or the letter to the Vice Chancellor, dated 28 May 2021, where they say that a college or an university can prescribe up to 40% of the credits per semester through online courses because of the pandemic. How do you calculate the credits? Credit UGC, as per UGC norm, 14 hours of learning is equivalent to one credit. Now consider it is a 10-hour course. So definitely students will be engaged in the video for at least 10 hours, if not more. They may have some doubts. They'll back and forth, they'll go into the video, just read it out more. So at least 10 hours will be spent in on reading the contents or viewing the contents. Then there will be four assignments. 10-hour course means every week 2.5 hours. So total duration is 2.4 weeks. So four assignments, every week one assignment. So they may spend at least 1 hour each. So if you just consider the 10 hours in video and 1 hour in assignment, that itself contribute 14 hours of engagement for the students per week. Okay, considering this, we say that, okay, 10-hour course is equivalent to one credit. But in addition to this, we have got discussion forum. We have got, just reading out the supplementary study material. These parts have not been taken into account. Considering all these things, UGC and AICT has said that if the university wishes, they can add this component and enhance the credit equivalency to a higher level. So that is the reason most of the universities who have adopted these courses for credit, they have made it 3 credit as equivalent to 4 or 5 credit, and 2 credit has been made equivalent to 3 or 4 credits. Even our own Macau, Maulana Abul Kalam Azad University of Technology, Macau, that controls the engineering and management education in West Bengal, they have adopted 2 credit has been converted into 3 credit has been converted into 4 credit format. Processes, I think, is not applicable for you, but if you are planning to go for developing the courses, you really need to know, okay, who will be the targeted audience, and how your courses should be utilized by the university or autonomous colleges for credit transfer. That means they have to pass the regulation, identify the courses, whether core courses, elective courses, whichever courses they want, to make their own policy for implementing the credit transfer. there could be cases where the students taking the examination from NPTEL or UGC or AICT, if they fail in the course, then alternate mechanism so that they can actually conduct the exam on their part and pass the cases. Keep it flexible that it is not mandatory for all. There could be many students who will find it difficult to take these courses coming from higher learning institutions. Okay. Now at this point, maybe I'll just stop a while, and if you have got any doubt, we can address it, or you can just give me a feedback, like whether I am meeting your expectation or not. What else you expect me to talk about that before I go into the next part? Can anyone tell? No one.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. You are very much successful. At least so far, we have understood what you want to share with us very clearly, and it is very much helpful for us.
No, my target is, see, if you are planning to develop a course, first of all, you should know what are the, see, if you are planning to develop a course, first of all, you should know which is the platform that you will be using so that the contents are reaching out to a larger audience. It's not that your college students will only be taking this course. To reach out to a larger audience, cutting across the boundary of the state or local college. Okay, if that is the, we really need to know which is the platform, how to get the course proposal approved, what all features that should be included in the course, then how the certification examination will be there. You cannot say that, okay, I'll offer the course only for studying, I'll not go for the certification. Usually in SWAYAM, that is not the case. So until and unless you have thorough knowledge, a complete tour of the whole program, maybe NPTEL is an example I am citing, but all courses, whether it's coming from UGC, your CEC, more or less structure remains same. Only the difference could be in that period of duration. That is, the duration, instead of 10, 20, 30, they may have 40 hours of lectures spread over maybe 14 weeks, 15 weeks, 16 weeks, something like that. That could be the basic difference. But the four quadrants that we have talked, most of the cases, everyone will be following those four quadrants. Okay. Let me go ahead with my presentation.
Sir, I just...
Yeah, please.
Sir, I have one question. So far, I have understood that the design or the curriculum that I was planning in my mind, and I have to approach the CEC, right? Now, my question is whom to approach, because I do not know the basic of or the fundamentals of the structure. So whom do I approach or whom do I ask for that?
Okay, just let me share you a SWAYAM course page. Okay, just let me open it first. Can you see this page?
Yes, sir.
This is, I have gone to SWAYAM. This is a course on programming in C. You might have heard about that. There is something called programming language. Yes, the people from science and computer science, they definitely know. Other people also might have heard about, there are some computer programming languages. This is one such example. What you see in this page, what is there? It has got, forget about the summary part. The course, let me just enlarge the font. The course is aimed at enabling the students to do certain things. The intended audience, industry support means, which are the industry that will appreciate this particular course knowledge. Then there is a course structure, books, reference books, textbook, recurrent reference books, biography of the faculty, how the certification process will be done, criteria for getting the certificate. Every data that you see in this page, these are actually taken from the course proposal. So a course proposal will need name of the course, who are the targeted audience, level of course, whether it's a UG level course, PG level course, is a core course or elective course, then who are the targeted, which are the branches of studies that will be considering this course. Because once you are offering this course, suppose a problem solving through programming in C, or even say we have a course on say communication, something like soft skill, then now the soft skill course is not limited to only humanities subjects. The soft skill course is applicable for all branches of studies. So you really need to mention the targeted course is intended for which group of students, that you have to mention. Then you have to, if you are planning for a course 10 hours, 20 hours, 12, 10 hours, 20 hours, or 30 hours, or equivalent to 4 weeks, 8 weeks, or 12 weeks, or in case of UGC, suppose your course structure becomes 15 weeks. Then you have to give a complete syllabus of that, weekly wise, which week, what all covered, what will be the coverage, what all things will be discussed in the video. Okay, maybe 2 to 3 hours video is usually considered per week. So that structure has to be given. Then you have to give book references, instructor, your bio data, then certification. Suppose it's a programming course, then definitely it's not only the multiple choice question that will solve your problem. You may look for something like, okay, I want to give them some practical problems. Okay, so you may require, for some people they may need, okay, I'll just give, I'll use MATLAB for simulating something. So all those things, the outcome of the course, that is after 12 weeks or 14 weeks or 15 weeks, whatever be the course structure, what will be the takeaway from the course? Here, the video here. Video, this is about 2 to 5 minutes video. This video will be there where the students, once they come to the portal, first they will look at the video. What the teacher is saying, that the things that will be covered in the course, in addition to what is written in the text form, in addition to that, and what will be the takeaway output, learning outcome of this course. Okay, that okay, after doing this course, students should be able to solve this type of problems, very specific outcomes. That needs to be mentioned. Once you do it, if it is for NPTEL, the proposal, suppose say IIT ISM Dhanbad, which is not under its fold, NPTEL banner, but now some faculty from there wants to offer the course, they will write back to us. Here, the problem is what madam, you have rightly said, that you really do not know anyone from CEC or UGC. Okay. That's unfortunate part. I also do not know who are the people there. But as far as NPTEL is concerned, we are very structured. We just give npTEL.ac.in. Offices addresses are given. Even you can find my email ID, my phone number, everything, all 7 IIT and ISC, every data is available. So that's how what we do. We disseminate the complete information through the portal. Even our all decisions, what we take on a week regular basis, our program implementation committee, all minutes are reflected in the portal. Nothing is hidden. So it becomes easy for anyone who is offering the course under the NPTEL banner, they can come here. But at this point, I really do not have any information regarding contact details of CEC and UGC. Yes, I can definitely try to find out, but I cannot sure that within 10 days time I'll be able to do that. Okay, but the process is the information that is available in this course page that needs to be put in a prescribed format. NPTEL has got a format of its own, but that format may be different from the format used by the CEC and EGC. But what I understand is that Professor Kanjilal from IGNO possibly will be better to, if someone can find out, I don't remember her name exactly, but she's Professor Kanjilal from IGNO, who is very actively connected with all agencies.
Sir, Uma Kanjilal.
Uma Kanjilal, yes. If someone can write back to Professor Uma Kanjilal, possibly that may help you to get in touch with the CEC and EGC. I just can talk only up to that.
Sir, quickly, can I ask two questions in this regard? Yeah. This is Dr. Malini Bas from Department of Microbiology, DCH
yes,
College. You spoke of the four quadrants. So those are in sequence, or likely to be, should be in sequence. So you said the first one recording, second the blog-like concept, and then again assessment and text notes. So like text notes and recordings that we are delivering to the students, whatever the course matter, etc. So it should be like assessment in between, or like one and then last and then the other two?
No.
What should be the sequence like, the way we upload?
Now, every week, if you go to the portal, what we do every, this day, 24th January onwards, the courses will start. So 24th, not only 24th, actually 15 days ahead of that, what we do in the portal, we just keep, week one. Under week one tab, if someone is enrolling into the course, they go to the course page, and on the left-hand side, they will see week one. Under week one, there will be five video, lecture video 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, five videos will be uploaded. In addition to that, next will be your assignment one. That is 15, 20 questions related to that week video will be uploaded on the same Monday morning by 9 o'clock. In addition to that, you'll have supplementary study material also included in that week one content. So three things will be uploaded onto the portal on Monday morning, mandatorily by 9 o'clock. Weekly videos, assignment related to that videos of that week, and supplementary study materials. After going through the videos, if they have got any doubt, they'll come back to the forum where they'll be interacting with the faculty and the teaching assistants, get their doubts clarified. Then they'll solve the assignment problems or refer to the, say, supplementary study materials, and then solve the assignment problems. We give them 10 days time. After 10 days, at the end of 10th day, that is Monday to next week's Wednesday, 11:59 of night, the assignment submission closes. After 11:59, 12:01, they can go to the portal and see their score out of 100. That is the maximum marks assigned to a assignment, they can see the score. So assignment and supplementary study materials, if available, they are provided every week. Okay, because I'll show you in the certification process, you have got 25% weightage assigned to your assignments, weekly assignments. Did I answer your query?
Yes, sir. And another question is, like, you said like 20 to 40% now presently due to the pandemic that can be taken. So we are following the curriculum as proposed by the university. So we can only now share with additional material to the students. We cannot take the things at this point of time, right?
Yes, actually, being an affiliated college under Calcutta University, until and unless the university takes the call on implementation of SWAYANG guidelines, possibly, or UGC guidelines, possibly the affiliating colleges cannot help themselves. Only thing, considering that, okay, it is their students and the career of the student should be ensured, that it's a brighter future for the students, their students, they can only motivate the students to take some time out from their regular activities and look into these courses, because here you'll have a lot of fundamentals. Okay, they may wish to explore something which they have not studied. I'll tell you, in the last semester, when we conducted the exam across the country in more than 200 exam centers, we had a of 85 years. Member from Madras University, she did two courses on German. At the age of 85, she had the thirst of learning newer things, and she took it. So even our students can be, say, even if it is not part of the credit transfer process in Calcutta University, nothing bars the students to take this course on their own. I can only tell you, all Ramakrishna Mission affiliated colleges, be it Narandapur, Belur Vidya Mandir, Rohora, your Bangabashi College, then you have got Gokhale Memorial Girls College, and quite a good number of other colleges from Kolkata-based colleges, they are actually encouraging their students to do all these courses. So if they find it useful that, okay, their students should be exposed to these courses, this is done through taxpayers' money. Everyone is contributing in this. So why we should not actually motivate our student to explore new domain of knowledge? Okay.
Yes.
So that's how you can actually motivate.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Now, I'll just take you a glimpse, like if someone is interested to join a course. Before you start thinking of, okay, offering a course, it's always better you join a SWAYAM online course. Whatever we talked about, four quadrant, actually, if you want to have a feel, you should join a course, maybe of shorter duration, and see how things are actually implemented. Then only you can plan it better. Every system has got some flaw, some technical issues, some limitations. Can you think of a better version for that? Okay, so I'll just take you through the glimpse. Once you go to swayam.gov.in, you'll find there are like course, which all courses are available at this point, they will be shown here like this, course names and other details. Okay. You select your course name here, find the course, click onto this course tab, whichever course that you feel. Then it takes you to the next page. I have shown you the course by Professor Anupam Basu, who is currently the director of NIT Durgapur. Okay. So this course data are available in front of you. What this course intends to do, video, course layout, and at the right-hand side, you'll find a summary of important points. Duration is 8 weeks, core course, starting date, ending date, examination enrollments ends on which date, which discipline, and the level. And AICT has actually recommended that all under the postgraduate level and say not elective courses and specialized courses will be considered as faculty development program course for the AICT affiliated college teachers. Okay, so all those details are there. Now at this end, you can just click onto the join button. Once you click here in the join button, this joining can be done through your normal desktop laptop. Otherwise, you can actually download SWAYAM app from your Google Play Store and also do the thing. Here, you will have to put your name, mobile number, email, age group, 13 to 100, everything is there, country, your profession, if you are faculty, you are student, or you are employed, or otherwise. Even homemakers, retired persons are doing this. So you mention what you are. If you are faculty or student, then it will ask you whether your college is part of a local chapter. So I am local chapter. As I understand, your college is not a local chapter. So you may consider becoming a SWAYAM local chapter. It does not require any funding. Simple letter from you is what is needed. And we created local chapter for you in SWAYAM page. Okay. So if someone is from your college, say student or faculty wants to join, they can identify, okay, I am from this college. My college is a local chapter. Then fill up other details, and this name will be reflected. If the candidate is writing the exam, then this data is reflected in the course page. You go to any college page in West Bengal, Swayam local chapter, or write NPTEL local chapter and just look for the IEM, EVM, the engineering colleges. How many people are doing from there? 2,000, 3,000 people are doing on a regular basis. So all those data, once you enroll, identifying yourself that you are from college, your data will be available to the college single point of contact, that the college will be identifying a faculty who will be acting as a single point, and the data will be available so that if required, the students can be given mentorship support, first level of escalation point. The faculty can be, and they can support the student in the learning process. After you complete all the details, some from drop down, some you have to fill it up. Click onto these two, click onto the join button, you are into the course. In the course page, as I said, that once the course starts, week one, you'll have number of lectures, you have got quiz, you have got a video. If you click onto one of the video, it will open here. You can see the video here, or you can just click on here. There will be YouTube logo. Click here, the same video will open in the YouTube. Here also, under this video, you'll have the keywords, metadata. Suppose you want to learn some basic concept on certain area, then you just search through that metadata. It will take you to the related video. So underneath the video, there will be some keywords saying that, okay, we'll be discussing all these basic concepts in this video. After going through the video, you have the, if they have any problem, this is the dashboard where they'll click onto the Ask to Join button, and here they'll be able to write their query, which will be answered by the faculty and TA within 24 hours timeline. Then every week assignment, if they click onto the assignment, this type of assignment, if it is a computer grading, multiple choice type of question sample I am showing, not green and red, these all not be shown, only the question and the probable answers will be shown. At the end of the year, you'll be having the due date, starting, that's when the last date of submission, date and time. That is Monday to next week's Wednesday, 11:59 is the timeline. Within this period, the students or the anyone learner can submit it multiple times. Only the last submission will be considered for grading out of 100. Correct option will be shown. If it is a programming course, like you have seen, your course has got physics, your department, your institute has got physics, BSc, computer science. Possibly you can expose those students to some programming courses where, in addition to the multiple choice type of questions, you will be having assignment problems also. They will be solving it here. There could be subjective assignment where they will be writing out the text, maybe within a certain time, word limit, submit it. Of assignment submission deadline, they can click onto the progress tab, and here the submission, each assignment score out of 100 will be reflected if they have submitted. We also consider live session, conduct live. just use the QR code scanner of your mobile, scan and see this document in original from there. So the authenticate can be verified from this QR code. If that means code is between 60 to 100, these are things I mean same. Elite plus silver candidate is code stock candidates who are successful in this course got more than 85%, 86% is here it is 94, that means she is course stopper. Usually what we find course enrollment, the students with this, since our reach is more to the engineering disciplines, that's our main, we definitely see that more number of courses are in data science, Python, Java, same trends in the industry, what they look for. Not only that, soft skill will be placed in weightage in getting employment. So soft skill courses here, they are also very, very popular. Patent, technical English for engineers, social network, introduction to research, this is a very popular course, and this is semester, but still we find few thousand of the learners will be the PhD students who will be definitely doing this course. Candidate does more number of courses, actually generate a multiple course competitions here. Instead of producing more number of individual certificates before, if someone wants to get this certificate consolidated form, they can generate this certificate online. All the courses done by the candidate will be shared. Every data will be available here. In addition to that, we have also started doing mathematics basic program. So if you want to be an expertise in a particular area, we have, if you can do maybe two or three core courses, two or three elective courses within a timeline of 3 years with an average score of 60%, can give you a domain certification. That will be because you have got expertise in a undergraduate program, is that exposes you at a larger tier. You have got an approach to something like program where your focus is on an area. Okay. So domain certification, currently you have 51 domains across not only engineering, you have got humanities, you have got management, mathematics. Faculty decision. For a school teacher, it is required that they will have to have be a trainer. Engineering teacher, usually they do not require any such training, but even teaching in a class of training, how to frame the question, how to evaluate, for the discipline where we offer courses from that area. So we six or more courses, 360 with minimum score 50%. That is the average score, 63 years timeline. domain that we offer from disciplines, humanities, social science, you can have English studies or domain certification program, faculty, you have advanced management, mathematics, you have got two disciplines, foundations of mathematics or special developed part. So these courses, these particular courses can be exposed to the students. So been getting opportunities, and these are the companies that they have got employment after doing the soft skill training. Okay, we can say special student faculty members, students, career advancement guides, so that if someone is interested in taking a skills, how do they prepare for that? IPF, what are the paths they will be taking? Or what the industry wants, who are looking for the job. Similar special series like us, and the students can actually join here if they have not been exposed to. Members themselves look into it, or expose these information or information to the learner. If they want, they can look into our repository and from there. Now, financials, as I say, looking for offering a course, it's not that course, there are certain financials are also supported by the coordinator. Okay, or suppose you are offering the course to CEC, submit the proposal to CEC, we'll check the proposal. Then, if it is approved, the faculty and teaching assistants with the course or the for recording of the financial support is given. For recording the contents, this will, as far as the NPTEL is concerned, becomes so. I'm just giving the example of NPTEL, other coordinators also, because the approval comes from SWAYAM board. So it cannot be X and something for Y, it should be uniform. So, faculty is paid, suppose there is a course 30 hours, if for creating content of 1 hour, the faculty will be paid 10,000 content creation. So for a 30 hour course, 3 lakh rupees for creation of a course. Okay, now during the runtime, what are other offering? You'll be providing an assignment every week. 5,000 rupees is given to the creating an assignment with detailed worked out solution. So if it is course, how much is the honorarium? Can anyone tell? Please per week. For a 30 hour course, it should be, it's the runtime is 12 weeks. So it's 1,000 rupees towards the creation and creation of the questions solution for that. So 3 lakhs for the content creation, 60,000 assignments, then comes your forum. Students will be asking the question that will be answered by the, so faculty will be paid 2,000 rupees per response. If it is a 12 week course, it becomes 12 minutes, that is 30,000. So 3 plus 3 lakhs plus 30,000. Then you have got at the end an examination. We conduct the 2 set of question papers of 100 marks each, because we allow the students to take a forenoon or afternoon and just a minute. Just give me a minute. Sorry for the interruption. So for creation of the question, it depends on the amount, depends on the course duration. 30-hour course, 2 sets of question paper has to be prepared by the faculty. So that becomes 30,000 set, that is 60,000 rupees for the question. 60,000 rupees for 12 weeks solution, 30,000 rupees for 12 weeks of assignment as forum response, and at the rates per hour, 30 hours of content creation will take you to X total. Follow. For a 12-week, 20-hour course, the means 3 lakhs, it is 1.5 lakhs. Now to support the course, run is for creation of your assignment for responding to the forums, some students, particularly the PhD students or master's students. Their honorarium is also 0.5 lakhs, 1 lakhs, or 50,000, sorry, there is a mistake here, 30, 20, 10, they are shorter. That means 10 hours here, the data is actually 20 hours, and it should be 10 hours. It's a mistake. Okay. So for a 10-hour course, for the faculty is 1.5 lakh. For the TA, it is for a 20-hour course, the faculty honorarium is 3 lakhs to the teaching assistants. And for the 30 faculty, I can ask specific questions. Any question, please?
Sir, I have just one more question. Suppose I design and I get it by the CEC, then I conduct the course as well to take the examination, conduct the examinations, or to use queries, etc., etc.
Absolutely, this is your course. So course does not mean that you will be creating only one quadrant. You will be creating the quadrant. You will be given access to the course portal, SWAYAM portal, so that all the content is there. Once you upload the content, the owner's way in a live portal will be with you. So it has to be handled very well. All questions that the students will be asked, that needs to be answered by the faculty assistants on a regular basis. Daily, the faculty and the teaching assistants has to actually come and respond to that. Then you have got assignment creation, uploads. At the end of the week, there should be, has to be published. All these activities are to be done by the teacher and the teacher. Only exam paper, after exam paper, you have to share with CEC. You can encrypt the question paper and share to them, because also, sorry, your CEC, EDC, they conduct the exam through the call NEET and JE Advanced and Adapted to an agency. So CCDC will be conduct agency. So you'll be routing your question paper with solution. They in turn will check the question properly and share the encrypted form to the exam partner. So some part of the activities are definitely faculty.
Thank you, sir. I'm clear now.
Professor Monali Chakraborty, you may
go ahead. Good afternoon, sir. This is Monali from Chandranagar College. Ask you that you have said that the college can be made as a part of your formality. So can you say in brief a little bit about how we would apply for that?
Is address, then we expect that university, while becoming a local, identify a faculty team, or even in some cases, even the librarians have become the SPOC. Okay. So the designated name, designation, email ID, department to be shared with us. Shared with us means it's not that it will be shared. If you click onto the form, it says once you fill up and keep that document ready through this Google form. Okay, it will open here. And through this only, once you submit, just let me not. Then it takes about 10 days, 15 days time to get it approved. No financials, only uploading onto the portal with the identification of contact. What benefit it brings to you? Not only that, okay, if someone is from your part of the online joined a course, you can get the complete data from there. Weekly basis, whether the kind of assignment, what is the score, the SPS will be able to see. Then, as we have said, NPTEL 900 online courses developed by us. Online content or digital content in the library is a, you can say, resource. So if you become a local chairman, that's a hard disk, and say, okay, I want all the lectures, chemistry, mathematics, computer science, English, economics, or humanities and social science in general. He give us those lectures. So hard disk will copy the contents and send it to you. You can put it ready as part of the digital repository. When he is interested to learn something, they need not come back to YouTube. They can see it there. It is something like they are accessing their regular library in a print format. Here they can see the regular resources in digital format. So that becomes easy. Okay.
You have given study materials like.
See, it is the format that Swayam is similar to Moodle only. Okay, if you want to offer the then the Moodle has to be integrated with Swayam, right? Because your students, learners, they need to come to a point. They cannot be diverted to multiple points. Okay, so say if you know Moodle, same Moodle structure is there embedded from.
Yes, sir.
So doing the things, if you know, there is absolutely no training these things in the Swayam page.
Okay, sir.
But it thank has you. To be through Swayam only.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Why credit is converted of 3 to 4? Asked by Professor Tapan Rai. As I said, 14 hours of learning is equivalent to 1 credit. For a 10-hour course, we say, so how do we calculate 14 hours? 10 hours is the video. Like, consider the student has seen the video only once, 10 hours. But again, there is a weekly assignment. At least 10 to 20 questions will require 1 hour each. Okay. So if there are assignments, then you have got, they will be consuming 4 hours of time. 10 hours on video and 4 hours on assignments. These 10 hours, we mark it as 1 credit. But in addition to that, in a regular class, are encouraged, and the teacher also asks the teacher student, you are not considering that engagement period here. So the students will be interacting on a regular basis through chat. That consumes some amount of time. Not that the student will be asking, the teacher will be responding. It will be a peer group. Suppose a course on economics is given. So part of that course, they'll be asking different questions. We're actually referring to their question and the answer given by the faculty. And the students who have got a better understanding, they will be responding, but it's correct or not, that will be vetted by the faculty. So that will consume some amount of time. The teacher is giving, say, supplementary study material. Student has to spend some time on that. Considering the engagement of the students, UGC and AICT has taken add one or two extra credits and convert three credits into four or five. Have I answered the things correctly? Any other question?
Yes, sir. Regarding designing the course, like suppose I design one, but I don't have the expertise in all the modules that IPR I am talking of. So that may have people from law, from industry, from entrepreneurs, all their appointment, their financial thing. So that's a coordinator agency.
See, no. Courts is not given to industry professional. Courts is institution or a faculty who is planning to offer the course. You must be hearing that, okay, parliament is and all, cryptocurrencies and all. From along with IBM. So, but the course is offered by a faculty from computer science is actually of any industry professional is a co-teacher. The faculty member gives up the course, the payment is made. So what we do, we ask the faculty how you want to split the total amount. First of all, 30 hours, you may invite experts from there, but the quality of must be vetted by you because it is your course. If someone talks bad about it, it is your directive. This is an open platform, whatever you want, you can, four walls. But once you are going in a public domain, you should be cautious. So record the contents beforehand. That we do here also. When recording of the much ahead of the course goes live, check it thoroughly. Assignments, question papers, they are prepared before. Once everything is ready, then only we send the uploading. Okay. At the end of the course, based on term, if there are five experts from industry class, this is your budget. 4.5 lakh is your budget. Okay. You tell how to be distributed amongst the beneficiaries. Give the name, we'll distribute it. That is how we do it. Similar thing must be CCGC. I can tell that IITs, they work in a different setup, very different. Whatever we do, we put it in the public domain. We could structure it in a better way because we are in 2014. UGC, CEC have joined a little later. And since maybe they are from different regions, they have got a different ambience and all. So they don't work close. What we do, whether it's IIT Bombay, IIT Madras, Kharagpur, we talk in a single voice. But that may not be true for UGC. That is the reason sometimes you find you may write UGC, but getting response may become late. It's not that they are inefficient. They work in a different setup. They have joined lately with some issue in that. But they will also cope up in time. So if there is no other question, we'll wrap up the session.
Thank you very much, sir. It was such an enriching and your simple and logical explanations understand all the technical aspects possibly. Actually, I personally very much related with this, like, because very recently I have completed my refresh of IIT Delhi through Swayam portal, and it was a total 40 hours duration, Latin weeks, and each week I use the reading materials and beside your lecture, video lectures were of 30 each, and at the end of each written assignment having 10 questions, two marks for each. I took a proctor examination. It was conducted and got the certificate after some time. Yes. So it was very
general. What intelligence is also for more or less follow the same structure, because guided by the Swayamboard. Every month, first Monday, there is a Swayamboard meeting. Everyone is representations that are taken at the meeting are actually followed by every agency. So there will not be much difference.
So it was very comfortable as I was doing my refresher course weekdays actually. So it was, and I felt very comfortable with such self-paced learning system. So end of our webinar, I express my deepest regret of my college, Rochadhadhar College, for being with us. Today's session, I request Honorable Rochadhadhar College, Professor Shyamal Kumar Bandyopadhyay, to give thanks and to conclude the session.
Thank you, madam. During about the last 2 hours engaged in getting valuable idea about MOOC candidates' vision and mission, I take this opportunity to convey to Sri Shiv Kumar, Shiv Shankar Das, the honor is webinar, for sparing some quality time with us to make us MOOCs in detail. I know that a small thank is not enough for you. I'm grateful to you for opening up a world of teaching learning which is need of the hour, particularly in this change. I convey thanks to Dr. Shu, the principal of our college and president of it, for his support and cooperation. Thanks to Professor Sengupta, coordinator of IQSC, DCH College, and PAP committee for her valuable advices in organizing. My sincere thanks to Maitro, librarian of Rochadhadhar College and organizing secretary of the organizing committee, for her great to bring this webinar in reality. Finally, I should my thanks to the audience without.
Thank you.
And for today's webinar.